What are the characteristics of a software engineer? That is, some peculiar properties, some traits which makes you a good software engineer. So if you are a software engineer, just a software engineer, you might be some graduate in computer science field. So basically you are using your technical stuff, what you have read. You are learning, applying these skills because you need to understand the problem. It's all about problem solving because software is a problem and you need to provide solution to the customer. So you are actually building the software. You are testing it because you have to ensure the quality also. But equally important here is the human aspect, because technical aspect is very important. But as a human being, as a human who is working to develop a software, in the field of software, because there were many people there. So Eldogmus, he identified 7 different characteristics, traits, properties. When a software engineer, he becomes a super software engineer, or you can say he becomes a super professional in the field of software development. So what are the behavior he is showing? What are the traits important to him? The first thing is, a super professional person, he takes individual responsibility. That is, as a software engineer, you have some work in your hand. You have promised something. You are promising to your peers, in team, stakeholders, management. So your individual responsibility is important. Acute awareness. See, if you're driving a car, you see here and there, the car may some mishap may occur. So if you are in HCL or TCS, any good company, now there is an environment, you know. So you have to be very aware of the environment and how to behave there. So observation and behavior aspect change is important. Brutally honest. That means if the design is wrong, the code is not good, you can very honestly, respectfully point out the problems, flaws, and this has to be a good criticism because it's all about constructive software development. If somebody comes to you, like your manager, etc., the management, and says, let us change the schedule, or say 50 requirements are there and we just have done 40, claim 45, just say 45 or 48. Or some performance issues, they can tell you that, okay, some file transfer is there and 5 Mbps speed they have asked, and we are getting around 3. So you can claim that it's as good as 5. So there are certain things, you know, you need to be very truthful and realistic in just denying it. Resilience under pressure. If you are a super professional software engineer, so pressure, chaos, frenziness, it comes in many forms. Because as a software engineer, and even as a human being, you will always be under certain pressure in your life. Because the requirements are changing, the priorities of the user is changing because of the changing environment, the business environment, and the demand which stakeholders put in front of you, they may be unrealistic, or the manager is putting all the pressure on you. So you don't have to succumb to this pressure. You have to be a resilience, you know, you have to take that pressure. That is, you know, you should not suffer. Your performance should not suffer. Sometimes people don't work or can't work in the pressure. Heightened sense of fairness. As a good person, individual, you have to share the credit, and you can just give the credit to your peers, to colleagues, gladly. Just try to avoid any kind of conflict of interest, because people work, they want their credit. So just give them credit. Attention to detail. See, actually, you are a technocrat. So everything is important. Performance, you have to see the cost. The quality should be highest. So the time, cost, schedule, performance, functional, non-functional requirements, all these have to be very keenly seen and to be implemented. Okay? Pragmatic. Pragmatic means, see, it's not Hinduism or Islam. that you cannot change anything. It's there, so you have to follow it. Whatever people say, you have to follow it without any logic. But here, it's all about logic, you know, making a software. So you need to adapt according to the circumstances, environment, changes. When waterfall model came, everyone was so happy. Oh my God, what a model it is there. But today, who is using waterfall model? Most of the people are using extreme programming, Scrum, and there is other variety of models they are using. So changes always occur.